What's going on, traders? Welcome back to another video. Let's talk about AMC headed into next week, August 5th, which falls on a Thursday, and why I truly believe AMC is going to make a massive move early on in the week or towards the end of the week, actually on earnings dates. If you look back at AMC historically, it tends to perform exceptionally well before, during, and after earnings. There seems to be some volume coming back in, which we definitely need since the volume on AMC has been kind of lacking. There is some speculation. Let's cut it out right now about the indoor close meeting. Is it FUD? Is he a shill? Just give it some time, guys. GameStop fell through the same situation in which it was in person. There was no live stream. They were asking us. I know we attended it. They were asking us what was being said, the numbers, and whatnot. They can't legally disclose any naked shorts or any manipulation going on with the stock. So I'd say wait for a legal filing, an 8-K coming out in the next couple days, possibly next week, maybe even some more insight about the company throughout the earnings call next week. So just wait for that, guys. Don't go out and be too quick. However, I do got to give credit to Adam Aaron for trying to fundamentally provide more value for AMC, not just streaming through movies, but through sports events. Got to give him props for that. I know, be very, very careful of him. I wouldn't trust him completely. Let's give him some time. Let's give him the benefit of the doubt. No more dilution. The $25 million is off the table, which I think was a bad idea. They should have just raised that capital. AMC is trading tremendous amounts of volume compared to other stocks, and I think it would have been a good time to raise capital, especially with this whole Delta BS going on. Let's hope we don't go back into lockdown, but I do think they should have enough capital to sustain another lockdown, which I don't think can be the case. However, just looking simply on the technicals here on AMC, there seems to be this massive bull flag forming. Is it going to make a move upward or downward, back down to 30 supports? I can't predict that, but just looking at the history of the charts, I think AMC can definitely retest $40, that resistance there. There has been some swings going on, 245, coming down under 40, testing mid-30s, and of course, we kind of closed down here, negative 3%, which I wouldn't worry too much about. Next week is definitely going to be a very, very important week for AMC. I know that seems to be the notion. Oh, it's next week. The squeeze is next week. Maybe next week. No, this week we actually have a catalyst for AMC that has historically proven to be a good thing. Just go back on the chart. Go back to my other videos. I explained this. AMC can definitely move on earnings. Let's be patient. As for the quickly before we cover the AMC SI reverse repos, go back to my last video. I predicted they would close over $1 trillion by the end of the month. Why? Because the Treasury general account has to be drained by the end of the month. There's still a couple billion left they have to drain. And where are they going to put that money into? Probably the reverse repos, where they could get some guaranteed profits, basically. Now let's quickly go to AMC before we end this. I don't want to keep this short. 15.21% SI. It's down nearly 1%. I saw people celebrating as it went up about 15%. But quite frankly, like I've been saying, stop being so biased. Get out of that echo chamber. To be quite honest, guys, are you either trust or use Ortex or you don't? Don't go for Ortex when you only see the numbers you want to see. If this drops to 12%, they're going to call this shill, it's FUD, it's fake. But when it's high, you believe it. Don't be like that, especially if you want to be here in the long term. That's it for this video, guys. I'll see you guys next week. Hopefully, you guys have an amazing rest of your weekend. Get rested, be healthy, stay safe. Peace out.